What's up, guys? Today we're going to be talking about interleukins, and these are all our little picture diagrams to make us remember our mnemonic at the end. Our interleukins are primarily made by our T cells, and they signal on our cells. And we're also going to talk about immunoglobulins just a little bit because they get commonly confused, but they are made by our B cells and they attach onto our pathogens. But they both work hand in hand with our immune system, both signaling and mediating our immunity. But let's get into the interleukins, okay? So our interleukin 1, it's our starting point, and this one starts the inflammation and recruitment. So it recruits our interleukin 6, and it also induces like a fever in our immune system. It's typically what most people would think of is our interleukin 1. Our interleukin 2 is going to increase our T cells, which is going to in return create more interleukins and the growth and differentiation of different T cells. Interleukin 4 is our humoral immunity. This helps with parasitic and allergic reactions, and it creates our IgE, our immunoglobulin E, which helps create histamine. Okay. And once again, watch our other video on immunoglobulins coming out pretty soon. Interleukin 5 is going to cause an increase in IgA. Interleukin 6 is going to help with our acute inflammation by increasing our CRP and our B cells. And remember, interleukin 6 is increased by our interleukin 1. Interleukin 7 increases our lymphocytes, so it's a recruiting agent. Interleukin 8 is going to increase our neutrophils. And our interleukin 10 stops the party. So that's the closed loop. That's the feedback loop that tells us to stop. So it decreases our interleukin 1 and decreases our tumor necrosis factor, increasing our T regulatory cells, pretty much telling our body to calm down with the inflammation, because too much inflammation and too much of an inflammatory response is not good. It would cause possibly an autoimmune disorder. Okay. So too much disruption is dangerous. So we need our interleukin 10. All right, so how are we gonna remember all of this? We have our mnemonic here. We'll look at our lovely steak, and you can remember those flash photos and glimpses from before. So I love hot T-bone steaks, like now, the end. So I love just to remember our interleukin. Then we start in a numerical order. So hot is for interleukin 1 because it causes us to have that fever and the recruitment of interleukin 6. T for the T-bone is interleukin 2, increasing our T cells. 3, we didn't really talk about, but it's interleukin 3, and it increases our bone marrow. It's not a part of that inflammatory response. Then we have our steak. Keep in mind what's capitalized. So interleukin 4 increases our IgE, and that is for parasitic and allergic reaction. Interleukin 5 is going to increase our IgA. And interleukin 6 is going to increase our acute inflammation stage, which is increases our CRP and also our B cells, which is our memory cells. Okay. Like is for interleukin 7, and that's an increase of lymphocytes, which is our T and B cells. Interleukin 8, as we remember, is for our neutrophils. Okay, we're going to skip number 9, interleukin 9. This one is also similar to interleukin 4. It helps with allergic reactions and increases in our IgE. And end is, of course, for our interleukin 10. It ends the party and it stops that loop. Thank you, guys.